so much. For next one, Professor Yoshida, Masami. Professor Yoshida Masami is from Chiba, University of Chiba, Japan. Today, his title is Innovative Teaching of School in Japan. And I'm told for the Thai people, he can speak Thai, you know. So if you long time to speak, to ask questions, you can ask him question in Thai. He can answer in Thai. Please welcome him.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much for the fine introduction. So that today, in the front, I would like to introduce an example of the media activity in Japan. That is a digital textbook. But in the backside, we had better have the chance to discuss about the extremely important principle, also the strategy about the mediated education. This is what looks like. Ha! Koto, I need my chair. Sorry. Next week, I have another conference. So the oh, the some differences. One of the differences is the introduction of the language, especially the English language in the elementary grade. You know, you will be surprised. So far in Japan, we have not any English training in the elementary. But soon we will install the new training in the elementary. Also the new concept is active learning. But active learning is still buzzword, you know. In the school grade also, many of the school teachers cannot understand the meaning of the active learning. So the Ministry of Education, they declared the new definition of active learning for Japanese education. Self-motivated and interactive deeper learning. It's very hard for the school. This is a new curriculum in elementary grade. Maybe you will be surprised to see the number. This number is hour per year. You know, in the elementary first grade, totally 850 hours. It's a small number. Maybe most of your country have the big number. For example, in Thailand, Thailand is very famous about the largest number. You know, usually the Thailand is 1,550, something like that, you know. But in case of Japan, we are very small. Also, recently, the science, math, and the STEM is very important in the every school grade. But in case of Japan, you can see the science is only the 400 hours, no, in the total, no, very small. On the other hand, physical education, exercise, you know, more than science, no. Well, you cannot believe about that, but we use this kind of the curriculum. This means that students, they must process their own learning by themselves. No, school hours limited in the science and other social sciences, small number. That is the characteristic of Japan. But you remember about this number, like music, art and handicraft, also the ethics and physical education. It's large. No, later on, I will explain the meaning. Also, to install the mediated education. We have the strong problem. One of the problems is the media. Usually, tablet is widely used in the world. But in Japan, tablet is quite limited. You know, this is the statistic. Tablet and the digital books in Japan. Very small number. Because the main data, we love to use the computer with keyboard. No? Also, that we have the, some specific terminal. For the game, we have the specific game machine. For the music, we have the specific machine for the music. You know? So no one wants to use the tablet. Tablet is like a mobile phone. You know? So the, in case of the, like, learning and mastering something, we usually use a computer. Is one of the problem. And digital textbook in Japan. Digital textbook have the difficulty for circulation inside the school because, you know, everywhere in the world, textbook is a part of compulsory education. In other words, textbook inside the free education. Students do not need to pay the money for the textbook. But many people say that media is very important. Media is very, you know, impressive for mastering the subject area content. But no government do not want to allow the digital materials inside the compulsory education. Now we challenge. Even the digital material should be included in the free of charge education. So we challenge, but still waiting for the time because our government is poor. You know, more than 20 years, we are very poor, but we still challenge. Also, the in other world, in other side, prior president mentioned about the importance of the free of charge educational content. You know, I agree. But on the other side, in the school base, they don't want like a free of charge content. They just want compatible to the textbook, you know, curriculum. All the time in the school, they want to have the, some qualified compatible to the textbook. In this case, we have the severe problem about the cost because most of the textbook company, they are the profitable agency. So they need the money for them. That is the trouble. So the, anyway, there are two kinds of the stream to develop the digital textbook that's compatible to the, you know, printed textbook. One of the consortium, the many company working for this, they try to develop the compatible common platform like LMS, you know, and put the content inside. But some company, this time I introduced this one, they developed some digital textbook suitable for the subject area content. For example, the science, math, and language, each subject has the different appearances because they're based on the strategy for the, you know, subject management. This is one of the examples of the digital textbook. Digital textbook is not EPUB, you know. In Japan, the countrywide, we provide this one, interactive whiteboard. It looks like a TV and a display, but actually the this TV or display will work with the server, you know. So the student also have the terminal. Server can accept and communicate with the big screen. This is the interactive whiteboard. The price like this, very expensive, you know. So the government want to have the suitable for the suitable contents for this machine. That is the beginning of the digital textbook in Japan. Digital textbook is not the provision of the information. We already have the printed one. Digital textbook should be the terminal for the communication between teacher and the student. And this is a function of the digital textbook. So the, let me introduce an example of the digital textbook in Japan. This is an example of the science digital textbook. So later, because of the restriction of the time, I put the contents inside the video, you know. So that this is the digital textbook of the science. Appearance is the same as the printed textbook. But there's a queue. Also, the one selecting the some point, immediately textbook change to the mediated style. You know, this is a preparation of the experiment. This also the another function, enlarge the part. Before the experiment, the teacher need to explain the detail about how to manage the experiment, something like that. This also the enlarge the content or the picture. So maybe you can find, once we decide to develop the digital textbook, production style is totally different. Because in case of the printed textbook, we have a long time history to develop the printed type. But once we decided the digital textbook, production also need the preparation for mediated version. You know, when we take the picture, immediately we need the preparation of the mediated video, video production as well, something like that. Also, the nothing so special. You know, every country can develop the, this kind of the things. But you know, importance is compatibility. In the textbook, we can see the picture, but this picture should be the same and moving to the, or like this, video. Okay, the next. Like this, the experiment also. No? In case of the printed version production, just only the picture is enough. But once we decide the digital textbook, cost is higher. You know, we need to prepare the production of the video as well, like this.
プレプラートを顕微鏡で観察し、細胞分裂が行われている。
Okay. So that is an example of the science based on the printed one, and try to introduce the mediated content as well. The next, I would like to introduce about the English.This is an English textbook, but they want to use their specific strategy for teaching. So that they, you know, they move from the text style of the textbook. You know, appearance is different, but the content is the same. But they mind about the function, like a reading function and something.
Does
like
Haruki live near a beach?
Yes, he does. He lives in Gold Coast.The city has many beautiful beaches.
Does he go to the beach every day?
No, he doesn't. But he goes there on weekends.
What does he do there?
He runs, swims, and surfs with his friends.
Not only this kind of reading function.
With his friends.
Also that they're providing the many functions, like a lighting board.
Yes, he does.
And the question and answer. And
quiz. Hi, Peter.
And change speed of the reading.
Does he go to the beach every day?
Flashcard.
No, he...
Like this.
Have.
しかも単数の時は動詞に S や ES の
This is the explanation video by the native.
さあ、
Can I find that? Usually the English teacher uses a variety of the technique during the lesson. They try to want install that kind of the strategy for teaching into the digital textbook. That is the strategy of the different one. Like this. Now, once we decided stick on the basic curriculum, we have the many things must develop for the digital textbook. Because that is the key to install the, those technology into the compulsory education. So the back to the presentation. This is the style of the delivery of the digital textbook. There's two styles of the digital textbook. One is for the teacher, teacher's education. Another is the student, student education. Also, the, you know, there's two ways for purchase. Now, one way is a download, 1 year contract. Actually, the, in the textbook company, they revise the, some part. Revise year by year. But as I said, once we change the school curriculum, we use the, this curriculum 10 years continuously. So the, many of the school want to buy the one-time contract by the DVD data, you know, two-way. So that depend on the school. But you know, because of the limitation of the budget, many of the school want to buy the DVD version. But it's difficult for them to update the content. They must use the old one continuously. Also, the student version. This is a digest of the digital textbook, not cover the old function. Also, there's a downloading version, also available for the student. This is the style of the digital textbook. Also, the company provided another available mediated materials, worksheet database. It's also very convenient because all the worksheet based on the textbook contents. This is an example. You know, all the worksheet contents is in the database, and the teacher select the part, and the part will develop as a style of the test on the worksheet. You know, teacher can select the part. Recently, they developed a new way of the technology, you know, to using the OCR. Once a student writing something, automatically OCR and go back to the teacher with the text style. Also, the another audio visual materials, you know, this is also the must pay profitable. I must say some example in Japan, you know, we have the big TV company, NHK. Also, the NHK have the educational section, NHK Education. They also have the very famous, like NHK Education Award, something like that. Now, many of the country know about that kind of the existence. They have the more than 50 years history and the content. That's why they already have the archived. We can access, we can use the qualified content of the NHK without any payment, you know. but the resolution is low. Once people look at that kind of content, many people say that that's very convenient for the older people. But in case of the like a qualified quality of the video, people must pay. No, we have the experience to show that kind of the content to the many countries. No, in case of the prime minister level, and also the minister of education level, and the director level, all the people agree this is very convenient, good for my country. But in the school level, no one wants to use that kind of the content. So we could find from the series of the study, school do not want the content. School want the explanation. No, explanation of the subject area knowledge is extremely difficult for the rural school, each school. They already have the content, but it's quite difficult for them to explain to the student. That is the reason they don't want to buy, because the content is different from Japan. So that we try to change the content to the more contextualized, but still difficult to sell. So that we can find. This is very important. We already know, because series of the study of the distance education, especially like a UK or something like that, textbook is the basics for the all the education, especially the mediated education. So we already know about that. But it's quite hard to medialize, mediated the textbook content, because the production system is different from the printed one. So that now we try, not only the production of the printed side, but also that we try to study about the production with with textbook style. This is the statics. Unfortunately, in Japan, we are poor. Now we are poor. So only not over the half, 40% of the school can buy the digital textbook. Remaining 60% of the school cannot buy because of the shortage of the budget. This is the benefit of the using the textbook. We already have the study. It's good. But this is a warning to use the digital textbook. Not only the good thing, but also we have some warning about using the textbook, a digital textbook as well. So also we developed some emerging technology inside the digital textbook is augmented reality. In Western countries, they love the virtual reality. Also, we can see at this moment, we can see the variety of the virtual reality application in the education as well. But in case of Japan and the Asian country, we love the AR, augmented reality style. This is based on the textbook. We put some mark as a cue, not like a QR code. Picture is a key for marking. And immediately appeared some additional information on the tablet. It's a augmented reality at this moment. It's available. Next is very important things. It's a newly this year developed the technology, in the education. We call the machi aruki, sorry for Japanese language, meaning it's a town walking. This is using the AR technology. This APP, application in the tablet, can support the student to produce, to publish in the internet. Also the augmented reality, the marker, GPS data, and or scene is a picture. I will show you the example by the video.
ここら辺に。店員入り口右手に左。 広がる庭が前縁です。奈良ざらしを扱う将軍家御用達商人であった清澄道生が江戸前期に煎茶を楽しむ別邸を建て庭園を作りました。
AR 技術を使用して伊水園をもっとより知れるような観光アプリを作りました。街歩きというアプリは何もない場所にスマホをかざすとそこに庭園の説明が出てくるような、で私たち造園 の学科なんでみんながもっと知らないような造園のことをこう広めれるようにいろいろ工夫して作りました。
一番初めのきっかけは、教育委員会さんの方から街歩きというアプリを使って、奈良県で何か面白いことできないだろうかっていう話を伺ったことがきっかけです。取材に行った時とかからは直接話を聞いて、でそれをまとめてっていうところで子どもたちにもほとんど任せるような形で進めてきました。
次期学習指導要領の中でアクティブラーニングというのが柱の一つとして謳われております。おそらく子どもたちはいろいろな説明とかお話を聞かせていただいて実際の政策っていうようなところにつなげていくということができたんではないかなというふうに思っております。
伊水園の学芸部長さんからお話を聞いて許可をもらって、でそれからそのコンテンツ作り、画像とかも分かりやすいように編集したり、その私は前園を担当して、その彼女が、後園を担当したんですけど、私の感覚で作ったらなんかおしゃれやけど見にくいみたいに言われて、そのいろんな人に見てもらうっていうことを前提にして、なんか画像を編集したり何かを書くっていうことが初めてだったので、あ、やっぱこういうことにも気遣いをしてやっぱ書くものなんだなって思いました。
本当にセンスあるものを学生さんが作っていただいて、それを授業の一環でやっていただけるっていうのは、まあ、地域の人にこの場所を知っていただけるすごいいい機会なのかなっていうのはありますね。
生徒たちというのは、まあ、日頃から地域から発信をするっていうところを意識してよく頑張ってくれております。まあ、そういった機会においていわゆる AR コンテンツの活用というものが子どもたちの無限の可能性につながると。
学校の中でプレゼンするのとアプリを介してもっと広い範囲に情報発信するのでは子どもたち の意気込みも全然違うなっていうふうなところを感じました。こんなことは多分できないだろうって思ってたことがどこかでできるやんって気づいたポイントがあったのかなと、自分たちにもできる、このツールがあったらできるっていうのが彼女たち自身が実感してくれたのかなと感じてます。
今回の取り組みで学んだことだったりを生かして絵も描きたいし、まあ、プログラミングとかもしてみたいし映像も作ってみたいし、
ちっちゃい頃からしたいことはいろいろあって、で、まあ、こうやって高校で珍しいことも学んできたんで、まあ、植物も好きっていうのもあるから、まあ、植物とかデザインとかそのデザインと別のものを掛け合わせるような仕事をしてみたいです。
Today, I introduced two things. One thing is a digital textbook, you know. And another thing is like a machiavaki. It's a SNS application in the network. It looks like a totally different one, but it's not a different one, you know. Both the activity is targeting on the how to enhance the mediated ICT education in the world. You already know about that. For a long time, we challenged to increase the GDP and the GNI in every country, you know, including the Japan. So that is the income of the country. If the income of the country increases, people will be happy. But at this moment, there's some problem about the equality. So Gini coefficients, should be equal. So the UN and the UNESCO say that all the students must have the chance to access the education, you know, like a EFA, something like that coming. Then, Millennium Development Goal. Inside the Millennium Development Goal, education is an important part, you know. Also, the indicator of HDI, Human Development Index, education is also the important part. But unfortunately, this indicator is not perfect because there is no ecological, you know, factor inside. Also, recently, in the world, there's a movement of the new indicator is coming. The guy cell is the most common at this moment. But unfortunately, there is no education inside. You see, this is a movement, you know. In the world, so far, the education is very important in the world. It's true. But that is just for the compulsory education. No? After student access the school, no one wants to pay the money for the school. That's a fact. So here comes the new criteria. Importance is in the social movement, like job opportunity, health, gender, and the ecology, sustainability, something like that. It's very important. First, I showed the example of the Japanese curriculum. You know, we have the limited science and the social science. We have the many art and the physical education, something like that. Because that kind of the activity is contribute to the social development. You know, many people understand about the Japanese people, you know, average lifetime is very high, you know, more than Thai people, something like that. Because we provide the physical exercise from the elementary grade. That kind of the thing is very important. Next, I show the example of the machiaruki. That's a school student go out and gathering the information, develop the service for the people. So far, that kind of the activity is a student project, just for the mastering the computer operation and the mastering the internet technology. But now it's changed. Because once government or local government asking to develop the service for the tourist, they must prepare the huge money. You know, once country developed, everything is expensive. You know, manpower also expensive. The once asking something developing the service is expensive. But if the school has some power to contribute to the society, like this, even the high school student can contribute to the society. That will decrease the cost of the social. That is in the future view. Why school must contribute to the society? It's very important. Without that kind of the contribution, voluntary mind, benevolence of the people, you know, our income, our happiness will not grow. No. So far, school is just for the mastering the school content. But the school should be changed to contribute to society. That is why. No. Even the indicator, there is no educational enhancement. That is why the school must contribute to society. Without that kind of the a strategy, maybe we cannot get any additional budget. Can you find? Okay. Thank you very much. If you have some questions, please feel free to ask me.
Okay, I have a question. Oh! Yeah. Oh! You are famous for that. Yeah. I know you.
some professor, mashup professor. Okay. Basically, I mentioned about the social cost.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, once country develop, social cost also the develop.
Yeah, yeah.
You know.
I get my question. Okay. So, how about happiness?
happiness.
So maybe you indicate about if we contribute to the social, we are more happy. But in your index, there is no happiness index.
Happiness index is not a you know, subjective rating, you know. Yes. Oh, that's a good question. That's why I mentioned that. No, school infrastructure facility is limited. But the student must know the you know, ICT and the cyber-oriented society. But the school cannot, in case of Japan, it's difficult. School cannot use the SNS directly. Like we are not allowed to use Twitter and Facebook directly in the school. So the school must have you know, specific infrastructure in the cyberspace. So the textbook company developed a service. So the school used that kind of service because without any fear of the security and violence. Can I? I need to make the concentration about that. This is a textbook. We challenge to the government should be included in the compulsory education. That means free of charge for the student and the teacher. Another line, this is a social service. Social service is a combination with the society. Like in this case, rural city pays the money for the SNS. Student contribute as a voluntary. You know, that is a mutual benefit between school and the society. Can you find? Also, the school do not need to prepare and the server and everything. We don't covered by the publish textbook company as well. Okay? So the, maybe the, we must know the coexistence between school and the society. You know? Social function can cover the, some kind of the cost. Please mind about that. No, that Machiaruki example is based on the Nara city. Nara city is a very famous city in the World Heritage. So Nara city pays the money for the SNS. And the student developed the content with the staff of the park. But once Nara city asking the you know, ICT company, it costs a lot. But you know, one time. But once Nara city asking the high school, maybe sometimes content have the mistake and the misunderstanding, something like that. But the school can support continuously without any cost. No, that is sustainability. The both are benefit. It's very important for our future. Okay? Any question? No? Okay. QR code. Oh, QR code. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for all two speakers for this for the first two titles, and I would like all of you to give a big hand again to Ms. Suji Lee and Professor Yoshida. Now we have a short break, a refreshment break for 15 minutes. And please, the third title or third presenter will start at 14, a quarter to 3 or 14:45. So please come back. Thank you very much.